What's up, everybody, and welcome to day 365 Making Songbringer. And today is a celebratory day. It's not every day that you pioneer your way into 365 days of live streaming something you have no clue how to do. It's amazing. Make a video game? What's up, Zynger? Check it out, man. I got this bottle of Sauvignon Blanc. 2014, which is probably not that great. It's got a twist off. In fact, let's save this for just a moment. We'll crack this top off in a second. Yeah, day 365, man. Wow. When I started all this, I had no clue that it would all ever get this far. Yeah. How you been, man? How you doing today? So yeah, we're just gonna do a playthrough today. Playthrough and drink. That's all. That's all that's on today's register. Check. Drink a bottle of wine. Check. Play the game. Check. That's it. You have water? You're 17? I didn't know you're 17. I'm 36 now. Shot. No shots. I got my bottle though. I got my bottle of Sauvignon Blanc. My cheap ass bottle of Sauvignon Blanc. What's up, Arcane? So what world seed should I do today? Six letters. It has to be an actual word. Today's has to be an actual word, all right? So, wait, I shouldn't be showing all these examples of six-letter words. Because all those have been tried. We can't do any of those. Arcane's on that list. Oh, this is already on here, buddy. I've definitely used your seed for testing many times. Because it's always been that one that has that one problem or whatever, you know? But now they're all fixed. Most of them. It's probably more. But there's other ones that have crazy bugs too. Like always, butter has bugs. Okay, why am I showing these? We need a six-letter word that's not something we've already tried to do a playthrough today. I'm just gonna delete my save game so it creates a new one. We're all ready to go. Stream yearly drinks booze. What's the first one? Yearly's the first one. All right, yearly it is. That's a great word for today. Yearly, we're celebrating this year of live streams. Perfect. Yearly is the world seed we're doing. So, unfortunately, I can only do 30 frames a second here in the game and 15 on the stream. But at least we're 720p now. So, okay, I got screen cap off. I think we're ready to do this. Let's see. Today I'm going to be playing with my PlayStation controller. Kind of excited about that. PlayStation controller, I really like it. I forgot how awesome PlayStation controllers are. So let's do this. I'm cracking off the bottle. This is a bottle of Pomelo. I like Pomelos. Do you guys like Pomelos? Pomelos are yummy, and I love grapefruits too. This is something you should never do. You should never just be drinking from an entire bottle of wine. Always a bad idea. Celebration day! 365 days of live streaming. Yeah! Yeah, right? Watching it do that little flicker thing. It's nice. It's very satisfying to have all six letters entered and then have it flash. Be like, yes, you did it. You entered all six letters. Your world seed is awesome. So awesome that I'm going to flash the screen at you. That's right. I can't spell ever. Actually, I'm a pretty good speller, but not with my thumbs, man. Whenever I'm like typing anything using an iPhone or whatever, oh my god, the worst spelling ever. Boogie was in those credits right then? I missed it. Boogie, thank you for everything, Boogie. All that's right. All that there totally are. You're not. You should be. Did you put your name in? Bird. Pedro's birding people today. Jeez. So mean. Man, I can't wait to do all these cutscenes here. There's a lot of art left to be done in this little intro. It'll make it more interesting, I think, to have maybe 12 different cutscenes there, pieces of art. Yeah, but you have the game, right? If you have the game right now, you're playing the beta, you can be on the credits, man. Hell, you should be on the credits anyways. Even if you don't have the game right now, I can't remember if you do, but like seriously, just write me what you want in the credits. Send me an email right now, man. My email is nat@wizardfoo. Here, I'll even type it on the stream. What's up, Magic Voxel? Alright, we're doing a live playthrough today. It's the 365th day, make it Songbringer. Well, in live stream days. In regular days, it's like a year and a half or so. You have a question? What's up, man? Exactly. Yeah, no, that's right. That's right. You tested it on your laptops and stuff. Yes, Arcane. Why haven't I got your name in the credits then? Have you sent it to me? Please send me your name again. If you already did. Sorry. But I'll get it in there. Can I do some art for your game? Magic Voxel, I do all the art, so... I want to keep it all in-house here with this video game. If you're talking about, like, fan art, though, feel free to do whatever you want. Yeah, sorry, Magic Voxel, I can't afford to hire anybody for this video game. I'm living on a budget here, let's just say that, to be able to make this game. Ooh, I'm exploring. I'm not going in the cave. No. It's a birds! Diamonds! What's up, Credin? The game will be released later this year. I don't have an exact date yet, but if you follow me on Twitter or Twitch or whatever, you'll find out exactly when. I'm gonna be making the announcement on when the actual final release date. I'll be making that announcement like soon, soonish. Like in the next month or two, I'll have an actual release date. But so far, I've just been saying sometime this year. Okay, so I've done a little bit of exploring here. I think I'll go in the cave now. I already know how to play this game. It's kind of fun for me to watch other people play the game. I'm so glad for all the live streamers out there that love to play Zelda E games. It's fun to watch other people play. Alright, Arcane, nice. You're cool too. You were always cool, man. You were always cool. I love how lighthearted this music is right here. It reminds me, I've been meaning to change the equipment map button so it's vertical. Right now it's horizontal and it's like all wrong. Gotta write that down. Yes, that was your email. That ping sound was probably you. Okay, so I'm taking notes here on my iPhone as I'm doing this playthrough. I do this when I do live playthroughs. I just write down little notes and stuff about the game that I'm thinking, like the equipment button right there. Select PS4 button is vertical. Alright. And I'm testing something here where I go into the equipment menu right as this boss is coming. Yeah, it still delays it a little bit. But at least it all happens this time. Before, if you paused right there, the guy would warp in and start fighting you while you're in the gear menu, basically. He wouldn't actually fight you, but he would at least warp all the way in. So that's better. Okay, hey, this is a spoiler alert right here. I'm doing a spoiler alert because I'm giving away a secret. This is a new secret, and if you don't want to know this new secret, either mute the stream or stop watching for about 30 seconds or so until the game gets into the next screen. I need ambience here too. This cave needs something. Magic Voxel, why don't you email me or tweet me or something? We'll talk about this some other time. This also needs some music, man. But then the music kicks in right here. Maybe the music should kick in right as that guy opens his eyes. Yeah. That music should totally kick in right, just right then. Be any kind of shields or armors. Yes, there already is a shield, man. It's pretty cool too. I wish I could show you right now, but it's probably gonna be, you get your shield like around dungeon 4, 5, or 6. It depends on what world you're at. Ha! Yes, I changed the minimap slightly, but no, I haven't actually done anything to it as far as what you gave your feedback on the other day. Remember we were talking about the mini map and stuff, and I think that I'm gonna make some changes to it, but they're gonna be subtle. I love playing with the PlayStation controller, it's really nice. Happy New Year! What's up, Jonah? My headphones went out. One of my left ear is gone. What's up? Come back to me, left ear. It's so nice having stereo with this awesome song playing. It's gonna go out on me right now. How you been, Jonah? What are we doing to celebrate? Oh, so much, man. I've cracked open this bottle of Pomelo Sauvignon Blanc 2014. And I'm drinking it. It's day 365. What's up, Silly Billy Bear? Hi. Ahoy. Arr. Your right ear died too? I know. I gotta buy new headphones, man. I've had these for so long. They're like duct taped on this side or something. No. They're electrical taped over here, and this side doesn't even have anything on it. It's just a bare... Salad dongs, ahoy! Thank you! I don't want there to be something there. I can't. Yeah. Whoa, sweet. I gotta work on that zoom in, but I've already got a note for that in my my Trello. So that zoom in, I want it. You could see that there's a little black pixels at the bottom of the screen. I don't want it to show those black pixels. What's up, the gaming artist? I'm not drunk yet. Wait, maybe I am. I don't know. Am I talking loud and stuff? I probably am loud and drunk. Acid. I'm only 60 away from buying it. Small demon's tooth. I need to make that clear about this text of what that is. I wonder what that is. What's that supposed to be? There's my email. What? Oh, was that you? Did you send me another email? Thank you, gaming artist! There's a lot of new story elements in the game that really make the game... They bring it all together so much. Freaking love the top hat. You can play the whole game with the top hat. I gotta make that work. I'm just following Zero. I haven't even seen Brutus. I don't know if Jib's died yet. Jib's been alive the whole time. Says every drunk person. Have you considered some black transparent background on the chat dialogues? They're supposed to be. Oh yeah, there's supposed to be a black chat. I'm not gonna look at it right now because I want to focus on the gameplay. But I will. There's supposed to be black behind there. I guess I'll look at that. Yes. Oh, Zynger, for sure. That will definitely be an achievement for playing the game entirely with the top hat. And that I think will be a pretty prestigious one, right? If you're playing Songbringer and you haven't beat the game without the sword, you're not a very good Songbringer player. Sorry. Just not there yet. I don't even want it. Nice. Oh, in-game chat? Oh. Oh, Arcane, yeah. Oh. Maybe I should put that back in. I have that. Okay, so the reason I did that is that I wanted to make it clear visually to the player that when you are experiencing these sorts of dialogue that are not as important, that they look different. So there's two different types of dialogue. There's the regular dialogue where the player is forced to press any kind of button, like the X button or whatever, to move through the dialogue, right? You have control over how fast the dialogue goes because that piece of dialogue is important. There's something in there that has to deal with the story, or you're about to get an item or something like that. So that's why those have a black background, right? And they have the button press that show you, like, oh, you got to press this button to proceed. And then there's the other type of dialogue where the players just are commenting. They're saying little things that don't really matter. They're not actually important to the game. So they're just more, I don't know, it's supposed to be more of a secret feeling, right? So, but anyways, I could try that. I could go back and try and change and add a little black background. Or maybe I could do some other kind of dark background or something like that that shows that, you know, that it's different than the other kind of dialogue still. But anyways, I probably just ranted for too long on that one. So I'll take a drink, keep playing. Or chat bubbles, right? Yeah, something visually different, but still is distinct. Yeah. All right, so I got the cactus. Somebody suggested recently that this room right here, where you get the cactus, should lock on you until you use the cactus. Because it's pretty damn important right here. You might miss the fact that you could go into this dungeon right here if you don't end up using your cactus. So what do you guys think? Should it lock you in this room somehow? So it makes you use the cactus? Or should you just be allowed to leave if you don't happen to notice what's going on here? What item you just got? You don't even try it right here on the screen. What am I drinking? This is a Sauvignon Blanc. It's a white wine. I don't have any shrimp to eat with this white wine. So, I mean, that's tragedy. But yeah, at least I have the white wine. And it stayed 365. Yes. Oh, Arcane, now that's a good suggestion. Yes, the cacti do heal you. Maybe you could get hurt. Or, that's a great idea. Check it out. So, let's say you come into this, this room right here. You're behind him right here. You walk inside here, you see him, you're like, whoa, whoa, what is he doing? And then you get here, and maybe some rocks fall on you, and you get hurt, and they block the entrance. So you can't get out. You're like, oh my god, I'm blocked in. And you're hurt. So you get up here, and this is a great idea, Arcane, because not only do you get the cactus right here, you learn that the cactus heals you as well. Oh my god, this is genius. No, totally genius, seriously. I gotta write this one down. Alright. Rocks hurt you and block your path in a swordless entrance. Alright, good idea. Great idea. Yes, I did give up on the vodka. I did not ever engage in any vodka. My shrimp levels, though, are very dangerously low. I don't know what could happen today. Oh, Arcane's cool now? Is Arcane cool now? Okay, so anyways, let's just pretend for a minute that I came in this whole area and right here some rocks fell on me. Like, oh, some rocks fell on me and they blocked the entrance. I can't get out of here. Maybe there's not even anything right here. Yeah, there doesn't need to be anything right there anymore. That art doesn't fit. And then you come up here and you find the cactus. You're like, oh my god, cactuses, what are these? They look delicious. I'm gonna eat one. But I'm gonna remap my cactus to the key I love, which is triangle. Eat some cactus, whoa. So, assuming I had lost some health there, I would have gained back a heart's worth of health or a tooth. I wish it was clear, though, that I'm losing Jib. I wish there was some way that, like, I forgot about this. So it showed me my buttons there. I didn't want to see buttons. Okay, so that, I need to hide HUD going into swordless. Teaching the game by an actual gameplay instead of just text is great. Yes! Yes, it is! Yes, it is! Credit and Arcane! You guys, have you seen the Sequelitis videos? You should watch the Sequelitis video about Mega Man, and it's totally what we're talking about right here. About teaching the player without bullshit. Dude, teaching the player without all the crap that modern games put in. Oh, press the X button to do this! Mega Man! Why not have Jib get blocked off from rock by the falling rocks? Exactly! Oh, Zaladons! Yes! Oh, that's a great idea. That would create so much tension between the players, too, right? Like, for a minute, you're like, oh my god, I lost Jib! And, like, he's stuck behind the rocks, and Jib's like, oh, I'll go look for help. Or something like that, you know? Jib goes off and looks for help, and you're like, oh, I'm stuck behind these rocks. No, that's great. This is getting even better. And what's so great about this is it's very simple now. With the current story system, it's like pretty easy to do these kind of things. Jib gets blocked by the rocks. I love it. Cool, man, it's so great to have two characters and to finally be giving them all of their own attributes and the character of the characters, you know? I love it. It's very fulfilling. Rocks on one side, Jib's on the other. Yeah, yeah. Pedro, you have 23 hours to deliver. Did you get all your feedback and stuff? Zero's Rock's father. Press the X button. Okay, what I love about this game, what I love about this game is it's different every time. I have no clue what any of this is. This could be a secret right here. Right? There's secret paths now. There's secrets everywhere. Woo. I guarantee there's some kind of secret in this room. It's gotta be. I'm looking for it. Wait. Oh, I know a secret to look for secrets. Still have a couple things to change. Damn, you have to write it on another 10 pages? Oh man, you got 23 hours of intense work ahead of you, man. I'm rooting for you. Dude, I'm totally missing out on the secrets here. I don't know what. There's gotta be one in this room, I'm telling you. I guess I am drunk. Nothing. What? I feel gypped. This room is not showing me where its secrets are. So, I have this on my list to do. I'm gonna have some kind of like dialogue right here. The player says like, or something. When you get to this little pillar here, you're like, what the hell is that? Why am I? But it does look special. You're like, okay. You can kind of tell there's something going on, but still, it'd be nice if the player, like, you know, related his thoughts at this. Oh, nice. Found it. Do you take Dark Souls games as inspiration or just Zelda? I mean, there are good ideas there, too. You know what, Kraiden? I think I do take Dark Souls inspiration indirectly. Because Dark Souls has inspired so many other games and is so great and epic, and they have such great game design that they filter into a lot of things. Especially what I'm talking about here is Extra Credits' videos. I love Extra Credits, and watching their videos is taught me a lot, and I've learned a lot about making this game better by watching Extra Credits videos. And they always talk about Dark Souls a lot. So I've played a little bit of the first Dark Souls, and it looks like a great game. It's just that I'm not as much into 3D games, so Dark Souls never really captured me as a player. So yeah, I mostly take Zelda and Final Fantasy and Solstice and Crystalis and other NES games and Super NES games and Sega Genesis games as my inspiration mostly. You're working on an application for your database class? Oh. How many money do you expect getting for making this awesome creation during a year? What's up? Is it Cheekhead? Cheekhead. I'm gonna call you Cheekhead. I don't know if that's right. But, hello. And, I don't know how much money to expect. But thank you for saying it's awesome. Marza, hello! Marza! Marza! What's up, Marza? Happy New Year! Marza, thank you for coming on here and saying Happy New Year and making a point to do that. Dude, Marza, thank you, man. I hope your Japanese trip is going good and you're having lots of sushi. Oh, you're talking about skeletons that keep reviving you until you kill the Necro. Or use a blessed sword. Oh, right. Kraiden, there will be a lot of that kind of stuff added to this game in the next couple months. There's going to be a lot more work on enemies and bosses. So, yeah. Thank you, Cheekette. Thank you. You're about to go have some breakfast? Nice. I got the lighter. Another thing I'm going to do to this room here is that right now you can see this blackness all over around the sides. This blackness is sky. It's like a pit or whatever. There's like, this is going down into the pits or whatever. But I'm going to make this water. The inspiration for this whole dungeon is water. And I think it should just continue right there. But it's weird. You have water here and you go downstairs and there's more water. Yeah, this might even be a pit. But it's not very noticeable. Nice, Marza. I'm definitely getting drunk now, man. Shit. I drank half my bottle already. No, wait, no. A third of the bottle. This should be noted. Hey, what's up, Asiri? Yeah, totally. It's very waterception, right? The waterception just happened right there. We were upstairs and there was water, and then we were downstairs and there was water. Well, there was sky, but that would be water. Okay, this is the secret room that doesn't have a secret. Either that or I just didn't find it. It's good when your game can totally surprise you. You have no idea if. I don't know. Does this room have a secret? I don't know. That's what makes it so exciting. What's in this room? Oh, what's this? Is this sand? Yes, it's sand. Oh, you know what, Arcane? It probably is the bitrate. Yeah, it's sorry. I mean, we're streaming at 720p here. This is HD stream, but it's 15 frames a second. So you're not seeing the game. You're totally not seeing the game at how I'm seeing it. So yeah, you just gotta play the game to be able to see it at its high res. All right, Marza, thanks, man. Thanks for saying hi. Appreciate it so much. So another thing, I need to make some dialogue right here, this room. Something that the player notices. Oh my god, what is this? What is this place? Yeah, see you later, Marza. Wait, I already... No, I haven't been here, have I? Oh, this is crazy. I bet you there's a secret here. Oh, I found the secret! Yeah, biodetector. Okay, so I want to look for the edge secret too. There's got to be some kind of edge secret. Mighty Nest, what's up? Thank you. Thanks for saying that, man. Thank you for checking in and saying hi. Appreciate it, really. Oh, yeah, it's Siri, right, yeah. So I'm looking for the secret in this dungeon. There's got to be some kind of secret. This room. Oh, what's this? Yeah, found it. Oh, so I just got the matter bomb before the first dungeon. I skipped to the second dungeon because I followed Zero immediately. And I got the matter bomb just there by finding a secret. So I have bombs now. I want to put these to probably button A. I mean B. That's where I like it. Which is the O button on the PlayStation. Forgot about that. So I'll save my biodetector for later. Yeah. Get the diamond! Don't leave the room without getting the diamond! Okay, we got a room to the bottoms and a room to the lefties. Oh, nice. Nice. I'm liking how this dialogue's triggering right now. So what Arcane was saying earlier there was that rooms like this, or I mean, when there's dialogue like that, oh, I found the secret! Yes! Oh, that was so fluid and natural. Scanner drones, found them, secret area. So there might be a secret path over here. Yep. Being the programmer of the game is really cool sometimes. But now it's getting to the point where this game surprises me, even. Like, I don't even know where some of these secrets will be. I like it. Oh, see, like that. I don't know. I wouldn't have known that was there. Yes, Chiquette, there is some stuff going on like that. Yeah, some objects have shadows where they are self-illuminated. Oh, you know, this dungeon, though, is meant to make you feel that way, though, right? This dungeon is meant to evoke mystery, secrets, and everything. That's why the shadows don't really make sense. There's some kind of light source coming from the very top, right? Coming down, it's shining on everything, always, throughout this whole dungeon. And that is meant to evoke the feeling that you're somewhere really weird. Like, what is going on? This is meant to be a psychedelic feeling dungeon. This is the swordless dungeon where you don't have a sword. Your sword has been taken from you. It's meant to. You're dealing with puzzles mostly. Nice. Love it. This game is really becoming very fulfilling for me as a player. Not just as a developer, but as a player, I'm like, oh, you know, it's starting to make sense why the characters are the way they are, what they're saying and stuff. I just noticed though that one more thing I really want to do to the game engine itself, the visual part of the game engine, is I need to work on the shadows. So like these shadows right here, you can see that there's a lot of black, right? And then this shadow right here, it's kind of gray. And it needs to. I need to work on the engine so that the shader I'm using. What the hell just happened? Oh! It went from daytime to nighttime. Oh my god. That's crazy. I gotta write this down. I finally figured out a bug that I had no clue what that would mean for the longest time. So daytime to nighttime messes up the shadows in Swordless Dungeon. So what I was basically saying there is that the blur shader, the shader I'm using to blur shadows, I'm gonna make it so it renders everything to a back buffer before it does its effect and stuff. And that will make them all look consistent. So these will be the same gray level as those. Oh, Arcane, I don't know, man, I forgot. I'm drunk. I totally forgot. Oh, Shiket, thank you. Thank you for saying that. Thank you for mentioning being a Kickstarter, but the Kickstarter's already done. The Kickstarter was last year, 2015. This game has already been Kickstarted and funded and everything. All right, we're ready to, I think we're ready to do this dungeon. Fix it up, finish it. Now, this is another part. I need to make the story clearer that you get this meditate skill. I'm not sure how to do this yet. But you get to this room, and the point of this is that you're growing as a player, and you learn to meditate. You know, you're growing. That's what this whole dungeon is about. You're solving puzzles. You're using your mind. You're not using the sword as much. You're not using combat and physical action as much as using mental action. And so I'm trying to find a way to ease the player into this where they get this meditate skill and you can meditate. And there's going to be a huge part of the game that's where you have to use the meditate skill to get past certain things. And I won't reveal that on today's stream or whatever, but like it's going to be an important part of the game, and I'm going to work on it pretty soon, so I'll get to that. But I want to ease the player into the fact that they've grown a bit, right? Maybe they need to grow a little more or something before you get this meditate. Or maybe there seems to be better timing or something where how you get this meditate skill. Like, I'm thinking maybe you actually interact with Zero somehow. Zero comes back, and you interact with him, talk with him or something, about, and then you get this meditate skill. That's a good question, Jonah, too, right? Is it a skill or an item? It's a skill. Yeah, it's not an item. But it's technically to the game it's an item, but yeah. Huh. I wonder if that's unclear or not. Well, anyways, I need to do something there. I need to somehow ease that transition. This part I think is gonna be cool. difficult. I talked a hell of a lot right there and kind of ruined that moment. But that as a player, as when you're playing the game and you finally accomplish that, that would be pretty damn sick. You're like, whoa, the door opens, I'm meditating and all that stuff. Fire, you want to fire meditate? This is kind of weird here with the sky. I need to make that better. Woo, diamonds! I really am drunk, man. Jeez. How much do I drink? I'm still not at half a bottle, but half a bottle is a lot of wine, right? At least I'm doing this celebration right. Day 365 is pretty celebratory. Arcane, Zero comes in and says, you are not worthy. So you go in and kill all the bosses, and in the end, Zero tells you that you are not supposed to find your inner peace. Not hatred, and leaves, and he also tells you that he is your father. But since you're such a cruel son of a bitch, he does not want to have anything to do with you. Spoiler alert! Where am I? What am I doing? Kind of weird the gym didn't play scanning. Okay, I need to make scanning. Dang. I'm even worse spelling when I'm drunk, for sure. All the bosses wanted was a hug. Okay, I guess I'll keep going this way. Hey, oh! Wow, we found a bug. Check this out. Brutus, this NPC, is behind the tree. You're like, what? Why is he behind the tree? Brutus can be behind a tree. If somebody woke me up from my sleep in the middle of the night like the hero does for the game of the sword, I would be pretty pissed too. Yes. Right? In understanding the enemy. Alright, this is all coming off really weird because Brutus is hidden by this tree. But this will be a bug that I fixed at some point. At some point, Brutus won't appear behind trees. And thus, the procedural game will get more procedural and still awesome. That's what's so amazing about creating a procedurally generated game. It doesn't have to not be bespoke. That's what people don't understand yet, is that a bespoke video game can still be a procedurally generated video game. Most people assume that because you're using random numbers or whatever to generate a video game, that it's gonna suck because random numbers can never create a lovingly crafted, you know, really, really intensely crafted video game. And I totally challenge that fact, because you can still lovingly craft all of the rules and algorithms that create an awesome procedurally generated video game. You just have to think about how the game is generated differently. You have to think about it from the perspective that it could go this way, or it could go that way, or it could go that way. You just need to make everything flexible. You need to work on rules, not, you know, rules and algorithms, not patterns and presets. Sorry, I ranted again. The tree is talking. Yes, this is a bug. Mm-hmm. There's an NPC behind this tree. Yes, Arcane, that's what I was saying. There are chat bubbles when the important dialogue happens. The craft flies and how you use the random generation. Right, yeah. I saw your other comment too. Just make Brutus a tree. Wait, actually, this would be pretty good. I probably should use a biodetector right now. Already got one. Sweet! Use it! What about a scanner? Do I have scanners? Yes, I have scanner drones! So if you're tuning in to today's stream or watching today's video on YouTube or whatever, I am playing the game drunk. This is day 365. Making Songbringer. It's not actually the 365th day. This is more like a year and a half, but counting weekends and everything. Anyways, we've established this room has a bug right there. Nice, this biodetector just revealed where the next dungeon is. Oh, what's this? Wait, oh, this is where I had poison and stuff? Oh, and you can buy the cactus all of a sudden. Oh, I don't need to buy any cactuses. Acid, I don't have enough money for. I want a small demon sooth. This way? Oh, I found it. I don't even have the sword equipped. I was like, why isn't it doing anything here? I'll make that there. See, this is something interesting. I need to work on making the meditate more of an item that's critical and crucial to the game. Something you use more. So that you would kind of want to equip it more. Right now, you don't use it as much because I haven't finished this really important part of the meditate skill. So it's coming. There's something coming where you can use the meditate skill to get through the game. Something I need to optimize, or not optimize, but like tweak basically, is it. This whole Verloc experience, this enemy right here, needs to be a lot clearer what's going on. And secondly, these guys right here. Oh no! I was talking and more spiders spawn. It needs to be clearer that it's spawning more spiders. But secondly, the guys that run it, what are those guys called? Pulverizers. These guys right here, these pulverizers. They are so aggressive and scary and stuff when they're down here in this bottom left corner. Because you can't see them. You're like, whoa, I can't see this because of the perspective of the video game. So I need to make it so that this room doesn't ever put like these pulverizer guys too low like that when you're in this is level one. This is the first dungeon of the video game. You can't be that difficult of a thing right there. So I've already got that on my list. I'll get that to that at some point. got bombs now, but I already had bombs. So I have 8 bombs I can use now. Whoa, I did not see that guy either. Okay, so the boss dialogue didn't play. But that might be because I went from dungeon 2 back to dungeon 1, so... There's supposed to be some dialogue when you first see these big dungeon doors, so... I just gotta work on the story system, and I already have a note written on my Trello about these big doors. What if you gave him a visual cue, like a glow? That might be really... That might help, huh? These are pretty difficult. Maybe it... That would really help, huh? I'm gonna put the note about that. Can I consider adding some kind of glow to the pulverizers? Oh, I know, the ambience. Have you considered adding outlines to enemies and characters that are behind something? Yes, I have, Arcane. I have. And that is something I'm still kind of considering. I'm on the fence about adding some kind of outline to enemies when you're behind things. Because every game does that. Every freaking game does that. Like spiders run behind the wall. Yeah, I know what you mean. I understand what it's like coming from your perspective, and in fact, I've thought that many times myself. I'm like, man, it'd kind of be cool if I knew where I was behind this big thing or whatever. But I'm so on the fence about it, because it would really change. It would really change the aesthetic of this game's kind of overall design. I don't know what to do about this that yet, but there might be some kind of like middle path solution where, you know, both of us could be happy here. Ooh, key card. Nice. This guy, Jib's dialogue played here this time. Another idea about the pulverizers, make it so that when the player gets close to the pulverizer's line of sight, it lights up, makes an audio cue. Yeah, an audio cue would help too. Yes, yeah, some kind of audio cue, right? It's so obvious, right? There should be something where the pulverizer shows that it's been triggered. Good thoughts. But a little red glow? Huh. Maybe. Maybe. Okay, I gotta mention that I have no idea where any of the like secrets are in this dungeon, but I have a feeling there might be a secret wall here. Oh, denied! I just used 3 bombs. Oh. What about here? Might be. Nothing? 4 bombs, nothing. Ah, my intuition. Where is my intuition gone? Yeah, Salad Dongs, I agree. Totally. There needs to be some kind of audio cue, because they could be dark or gone. Totally gone. Like, what? I don't know where that guy... where that guy went, where he came from. The sound really helped to trigger. So just make it clear to the player. I know what to do here. Oh, there might be a secret here, but I don't want to waste all my bombs. Oh my god. I kind of have the advantage that I've already fought all these enemies and stuff a bajillion times, so. Is that a visual bug? When you place the mine, the number that was on the HUD indicated. Yeah, that was a visual bug, yeah. That's on my list already. So there's like, when the HUD fades out, that's a new thing, right? The HUD fades out when you've, when you're kind of done using it, the game is kind of resets itself to a visual state, like, you don't need this stuff, you've been here for a while. Like now, it's like, you've been on the screen for a while. But as soon as I pick up this diamond right here, it's gonna show the HUD again. I got 100 diamonds. Because it shows you, as soon as you pick up an item or you re-equip something or you know, important stuff happens, it shows, it pings the HUD automatically, basically. Yeah, I know. Yeah, the number stayed there. Yeah. Thanks for sharing that. Yeah, that's on the list already to fix. Overall, in the whole process of making Songbringer, this is a year's worth of live streams. This is a year and a half's worth of real time. We're about, I would say about 75% of the way to finishing Songbringer. Items in the middle of these two pillars here. Oh, do I want to try bombing here? Last time I tried bombing, it just didn't do anything. I'm trying to think of where would be the most likely place for the dungeon generator to put a secret wall. Probably not here. I got a key. This dungeon is kind of confusing for level 1. I might need to make level 1 a little easier. I've been thinking about that. Maybe level 1 should have not as much going on, because you have to go find. There's a lot of things to figure out. You have to figure out switches. You know, the main thing where you find this room and you defeat all these enemies and it opens up the switch room, that needs to be clear. But there's a lot of that going on in the first dungeon. You have to find the gate item, the bombs. You have to find the switch room, which can be hard to find as well. So there's two kind of intellectual things you have to figure out in the first dungeon. And I'm thinking maybe you should only have to figure out one thing. First dungeon. The third dungeon. Or second dungeon, or whatever. Whatever dungeon comes after this one. That's where you finally have to combine both game mechanics into one. Defeat both in one dungeon. That would probably help dungeons feel a little more varied as well, because the first dungeon you experience doesn't have two mechanics. Oh, nice. Barely picked that up. not failed me yet in this playthrough, but he has in other playthroughs recently. I need to work on him some more. Another biodetector. I love playing different worlds. It's nice to be surprised by a video game every time you play it. That's my main gripe with all the latest Zeldas. I don't like them as much because every time you play it, it's the same damn thing. It's so sweet to have a Zelda video game where it's got all the story and all these other rad elements. It just sucks that you have to know what you did. This is the first time you play it, you play through the whole video game. Next time you play it, you just already know where everything is. It's the same thing with Hyper Light Drifter. Like, I love Hyper Light Drifter so much. It's such a rad video game, but it's not procedural. The next time I play it, I already know where everything is. I already know where all the secrets are. I already know where all the enemies are. I already know where, like, how to beat each boss. I guess this video game, you would always know where how to beat each boss as well. Whoa. I don't see anything that shows where... This might be a broken dungeon. Wait. It's right here. That's what happens when you're drunk. You can't tell where the little things like that are with the map. Thank God the map's bigger than it was last week. You get interested in the top hat? Yay! Check out my top hat! These little corridor rooms with lots of little blobs are actually kind of a combat exercise almost. This is really interesting how this room came out with the access to the switch room here. Wow, cool. Oh no, it caught me. Run away! Ooh, I'm down to half a heart. Try to play a video game drunk. Nice. So, one other thing, I need to make this clear that this switch opens the boss door somehow. I'm thinking what needs to happen right here in this room when you clear a switch for the first time is that it'll fade out. Fade back into the boss room and open the doors just slightly. The boss doors go and then it fades back out, fades back into this screen. So basically a little tiny quick cutscene to show you that what you did here in this room just affected something else in the whole dungeon. Because, you know, people playing this video game that haven't watched these live streams, you haven't played a Zelda game before maybe, understand, you know, it's not very clear that little electricity thing just opened up something else. Lost. This is a hard dungeon. This is hard for level one. What is so difficult about this? This really shouldn't be this difficult at level one, should it? That effect would have been better, actually, with a little more delay. Level one, that guy was easy as hell. I don't even think I dropped a bomb. He died so quick. Wow, I didn't even lose any health. How do I have 5 health already? Make a lot of progress fast. Ice, Blake Orb. Beat 2 dungeons so far. What do we got in this? Any scanner drones left? Scanned already part of the world over there. No scanner drones though. Except I got a biodetector, I'll use that. Minutes, man. Let's see what else I can find for a minute. Is anybody still there on the live stream? I might have lost you guys a minute ago. I'm gonna use a cactus here. Oh yes, secret. Found. And I happen to have bombs to take advantage of this secret. You aren't here? Everyone left? Oh, cactus pouch! Oh my god, this is a really great find. This stream sucks. Cactus pouch! I got 6 cactuses now. That was weird. It showed one type of it. Where am I? I'm at 6. 1, 2, 3, 4. 6, 4. Alright. I gotta write down what this area is so I can come back to here and fix that bug. Mountain cave entrance. The world seed was yearly, and it was 640. Kappa. So he did not play the bummable. There's this dialogue is supposed to happen when you first encounter those guys. Man, I'm a horrible speller when I'm drunk. Look at these guys hanging out here. They're like, yeah, this is our domain. They're tough little bastards. You have to add a special debug key that writes the current room location. Yeah, I already got that. It's already got that. It's Y. You press the whatever. No, you can map it to whatever you want. There's this thing in your saves.txt where you can add a key that does all these commands. You could do God mode even. You could do this debug command, which shows you all this rad stuff about where you are in the world. You got you can slow down time. You can speed up time. You can do God mode, invincibility, kill yourself, or kill everybody else. PC Warrior! But I do! I played the wrong dialogue there. I had bombs. Wait, I already have bombs, right? Yeah, I've got two bomb containers. And I played the wrong dialogue because it's supposed to play the dialogue. So many bugs. So many bugs, so little time. Bumble 2. Wait, no. Bumble 1 played. And I already had bombs. Luckily, there were some bombs there. Store. Ooh, we got a jib light. I could buy. What's this? Just some bombs? Just some cactus? Oh, all I can buy is a jib light. I'll buy. Yeah, jib, now you got a brighter light. Aren't you excited? I gotta make these guys stagger at a different rate. I think that's already on my list. No more bombs. I was like, come on. There's gotta be some things to bomb around here. Whoa! Intelligently. like it's too easy to be accidental at this point. You can double tap so easily. The double tap makes you use it. With this PlayStation controller, it's really easy to double tap, basically. It's so fast and awesome. It's a rad controller. I like this controller a lot. This would be really nice if this guy was different for the next dungeon. But I'll get to that. I'll get to making all the enemies in the game complete. Music played kind of weird there that time. I have bombs again. Oh, ghost sword. Nice. Oh, I forgot how awesome the ghost sword is. It's like been a minute since I had one of these. And the blink. Shit. This game really rewards you. Especially if you're drunk. If you're drunk, you just appreciate everything even more. I can't wait to make more enemies. Oh. The game does have to be feature complete soon. Oh, Jim, please, I need some help, man. That's six cactuses. I need a cactus. Just for the hell of it. Psychedelic shadows! Might as well kill this pillar right here because I already chopped it down. Oh, I found a diamond inside that one. What's behind door number A? What can we find on this lonely path? I guess it's not very lonely. There's giant goat-headed demons in this room. A key. I think I know what that was. So, what do you think? Secret wall? Probably not. There's probably not a secret wall right here. The minimap is giving me plenty of indication that it's not a secret right there. It's a flaw of the minimap, actually. If you know how to read the minimap, you can tell that a certain area might not have... Oh my god. Eat a cactus. This room deserves a cactus. I think I had a cactus. I think I found that secret that gave me two cactus containers already. Fibers. I need a bigger diamond sack. This game, this had all fibers. More bombs. All fibers. Every single enemy in this. Almost every enemy had fibers. I got 200 diamonds now. Ready to spend some money and upgrade this ghost sword. Nothing. Possible. Yes! Finally! We'll find a secret in one of these dungeons. This room itself could have a secret. What we got here? Oh, it does! What do we got here? Scanner drones. Take it! Help me, really. But some worlds, some speedrunners are gonna be so glad that that was there. This is quite a twisty maze. I don't know where to go. Get me. These guys are horrible. Really gotta work on the intelligence for them. Hey! Last one blobs. This is the lot more enemies once the game's done. And it won't seem so repetitive fighting dungeons over and over and over. All the enemies will be different. The dungeons will have different puzzles. Different dungeons will have different art. It really helps make the game feel more complete. Wow, I'm almost dead. Once again, I'm thinking no secret rooms around this. Not a high likelihood. There's still a possibility, though. I could be totally wrong. There could be a secret room right off of that one. Or here. There totally could be. There could be a room right to the right of this or left. Do I want to waste any bombs trying? I got 12 of them. Hell, let's try. It's nice having a lot of bombs. You don't have to worry about nothing. Yep. Nap. So what just happened? I got the boss room complete. Where? I guess it must be straight north or to the right. There's an empty room in the middle of here. That looks like the ultimate place to put a secret room in a dungeon if I were a dungeon generator. But there's not gonna be any secret there. Yet. Oh, that would be a sweet secret actually, to put some kind of like invisible path right here. You could walk right there. I like that idea a lot. Visible paths over sky. Here's another one where there could be an invisible path over the sky. Kind of be a clutch place to have some kind of secret. So I think I gotta go this way. Oh, backward throw. It's easy when you really know your game pretty well. Oops. Good night. Oh, I totally thought I would have got that guy too. Oh, you're nothing! Wah boss, level 3. Coming out of this dungeon rich. Oh, I got the teleport cube! It actually saved the right pillars right here. So there's a store back that way. I think I should go south. I'm looking for another store. Ah, I found one! to Scott. Matter bomb container? Oh, I'm thinking so. Yeah, let's get that. I got a ton of bombs. I already got scanner drones. I'm gonna use some of those. Well, we're done. How did it go today, huh? Day 365, making Songbringer. Half a bottle of wine. I swear if I drank this entire thing, I would be plastered. I never drink much, so. So anyways, day 365, look at this. How far? We got three dungeons deep into Songbringer, in the beta version. There's a lot left to do to make this game better, but I'm pretty satisfied. I'm very satisfied with how things have come, how the progress has really been very satisfying developing this video game. I know, I'm totally slurring, right? You can tell, you can fully tell. Hopefully, Pedro, hopefully! Thank you, by the way. So yeah, I guess that's it for today's stream. I know it has come a long ways, right? Yeah, it's been a year and a half of streaming, and a year and a half of developing. I've developed from day one making this video game. So, yeah, there's a hell of a lot of live streams on here and all the way from the very beginning. Yeah, thanks, Jonah. Ooh, I guess I can craft something before I go. Yeah, this last quarter of the game's development or so is, you're gonna see exponentially better stuff coming, because that's what happens with a video game. You get, once you get all the systems in place and stuff, it becomes really fast to be able to do new things, and you get so much more exponentially. You're like, whoa, there's so much new stuff in this video game since last time I saw it. Because it's really easy to add stuff. I can add new puzzle elements, new story elements, so fast now. And pretty soon the game will be feature complete, which means, like, man, at that point, it's just easy to add stuff even more. So what should I get? Poison Top Hat or Poison Ghost Sword? I'm thinking either of those would be sweet. Poison Ghost Sword? I'm thinking Poison Top Hat. Whoops. Which one's square? Oh, that's square. Concludes today's live stream. I got, let's see, what do I got? How many? I got 34 cards I'm trying to work on today. All these things, all these little bugs. In fact, some of these things I just added to the soon list, I'll probably move over to the now list as well. So I got a lot of work ahead of me today. I got to sober up a little bit, take a shower or something, drink a lot of water, maybe drink some coffee. You know, have a big dinner, take a nap maybe, and then get back to doing all these 34 cards. And then I'll get to these soon cards. There's 82 cards there. And then finally I'll get to these later cards, 67 cards. A lot of work left with the game. Yeah, see you guys. Have a great day. Have a great night. And I really appreciate you all. Always.